So Brad and I have been hired to build a truck inspired by the F-22 fighter jet.
We're a few weeks away from bringing the truck to the EAA show where there's over 500,000 people.
The design's been approved, and the truck we're gonna build just arrived. But there's one small problem.
A big problem.
Actually, it's a big problem. Wrong truck.
I know.
It's an extended cab.
I know. I was asking him, I was like, is there another Raptor? It's the wrong one.
I look at the truck, and it's not a crew cab truck. It's an extended cab. And I'm thinking,
I picked
there
that thing up.
No way.
A crew cab is a complete four-door with a full bench seat in the back. An extended cab is a half-opening rear door with a lot smaller legroom and a lot smaller seat in the back.
Should I even unload it yet?
No. It's the wrong truck. It doesn't sound like that big a deal. The problem lies is we've got all the parts. Everything that we got approved, all those are pretty much out the window. So I immediately called the client. Well, I mean, no, it has four doors, but it's extended cab. I need a crew cab. No, I'm telling you. Call me back.
He didn't believe you?
Well, no, because he's flipping right now.
Everything changed when we saw that truck come in on the trailer.
Hey, buddy. Okay, bye. He said they looked up the order on it, and they ordered a four-door. So he thought he ordered it right, but you have to order a crew cab.
Like, we have time for that.
Well, we don't have a choice.
We have 4 weeks to finish this thing, and now we're starting over. So it makes that clock that was ticking fast even faster.
Junior gets to feel a little stress, feels like, in the automotive world. It's gonna be good. So it's a new day. We got the truck all torn down. Now it's time to turn this thing into something that screams F-22 fighter jet. So we got rid of the factory step. We installed an amp step where you open the door, step comes out. Then when you're out cruising out in the dunes, the thing sits up nice and tight so it doesn't get ripped off.
All right, so we just got these lights in.
Yeah, so we need to put that in there.
We need to put this in the bumper, but it can't look like we just like placed it there. I know if it doesn't fit, my dad's gonna make fun of me.
Hey, the only reason I do that, because it keeps him on his toes, and he's double, triple checking it on that computer. Well, let's see how good Junior did. We got lucky.
That is not a light tire, huh? So going to the bed of the truck, we're gonna do a real nice spare tire rack. This truck is meant to, you know, be on the street, but also in the middle of the desert. So I want two tires, I want a fuel can and a jack. We could do like a jack here. We could do a fuel can in the middle on the side.
What are you guys doing?
So I invited my buddy Madera out to help us with some ideas for the rack.
Waiting for you long enough.
Not even a high? Damn it, Doug.
Really?
Madera is probably the best fabricator I have ever seen in my life. Madera worked for me for a long time, 20 years. The guy is like a genius.
What I'm wanting to do is two spare tires in the back.
Why two?
You guys want to do four?
No. What the hell?
But his patience are this big right here.
Yeah.
Don't you think it's the most?
He doesn't have much patience.
We can just kind of play it by ear, I guess.
Yeah.
Why does it have to be played by ear? Well, I don't know what that means, play it by ear.
It's a figure of speech, dumbass. Me and Doug have like a love-hate relationship.
Doug!
Majority of the time, I hate him. I drew the bracket, already transferred it over onto the program, and let's cut it.
I like working with Madera because he has awesome ideas. I learn a lot working side by side when he's making brackets or messing with tubing or welding. Nice, Madera.
The thing about Brad is he's actually a really good builder. I mean, don't get me wrong, sometimes he is a pain in the ass. But he likes to learn, he's real disciplined. He just tries to be the best at what he can do, and that's what makes him so good. He loves building and he loves racing. So trying out for a NASCAR, he'd be able to do it. I'll put money on it.
That is awesome. It's like, ah!
This is so different than any other setup that I've seen. It looks like the jack's just floating.
Oh. at that.
Oh my God. That is
incredible.
That's insane. We're in Oshkosh. Begosh.
This is the largest air show in the world. Yeah. I've never seen nothing like it. It's airplane after airplane after airplane and tents. What the heck is that? We're at an air show, dummy. The best news we got is the truck made it here safe and sound. And Ford loved everything we did to it to give it that F-22 theme. Everything from the custom paint, to the prototype suspension, to the crazy tire rack where the jack looks like it's floating, and all the awesome lights and one-of-a-kind features we put on it.
You know, next time we're gonna see this truck, it's gonna be on the stage, getting ready for auction. We're gonna be sweating bullets. We'll see, you know, when it comes down to it. For this job to be a true success, it's best for the client that it auctions off at a high number.
So me and Brad are sitting next to each other, and they start auctioning off the F-22 Raptor.
Let's start the bidding, let everybody in. Who's got $25,000? Who's got 50, 75?
And that thing starts off at 50 grand.
50, 75, 50, 75, 225, 225, 250.
And then it kept going.
Pop in 225 and then 250, 75 now. The bid on the truck is at $300,000.
Finally, they stop it at 300 and we're like.
Going once, going twice. Sold at $300,000.
$300,000 for the truck we built. It's unheard of. It was just immediate, like, accomplishment for everything that we did.
It definitely validates pretty much everybody that had a hand in that, that truck.
Our team.
Madeira, the team.
There is going to be many more vehicles that leave the shop.
A lot. There has to be. He wants to race NASCAR.